every time I upload a video, you'll be the first one to watch. And show love to my videos by leaving a comment, and also you may like and share. And for the returning subscribers, I really want to appreciate you so much. Remember that we are rooting to 5,000 subscribers, and I know you will gonna get there very soon.
And today I'm one-on-one with the deputy head of institution, Isacko, primary, junior and secondary. So welcome, Mr. Wabuche. Welcome.
So we find that when this food comes, the enrollment is increases daily, maybe timely, because the learners' nature here is pastoral. When they get out, they find that there's no food outside there. When they come to school and they don't get food, they disappear, majority. But when there's food, the learning is more.
Okay.
attend learning, they come, there's no a lot of truants.
Okay.
So feeding program generally is very okay.
Mm-hmm.
Although sometimes maybe the length of supply
mm-hmm.
Due to from a delivery point, maybe full majuk.
Okay.
But generally when it comes,
mm-hmm.
we are very coordinating with the sub-county director,
okay.
ministry.
Okay.
So things are well.
Okay, how do you get water?
Water, we have different tanks
mm-hmm.
for storage.
Mm-hmm. Whenever, within the school?
Within the school.
Okay.
Whenever there's a rainfall,
mm-hmm.
we get some storage. But we also have a well. The challenge is all that the well is salty.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes it's a challenge. When during dry season, water tanks, they come to an end. Then the well, water from the well, is the only source.
Yes.
It forces us to drink, use for cooking,
yes.
but it's not very healthy.
Okay.
So we are appealing to well-wishers and NGOs to do something more
okay.
so that we can maintain the system.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. What about the challenges your times go through in this place?
General challenges here. You know, as you see, the conditions are harsh. Here conditions are harsh, especially the environment. You know, during dry season,
mm-hmm.
it finds it very hard even attending afternoon classes because it's too hot.
Yes.
But we have coped up with it. Then, another challenges we have distance from the residential places of learners.
Mm-hmm.
Some learners come as far as 10 kilometers. So it takes much of the time walking to and from the school. So you find that maybe morning preps sometimes affected. When they go afternoon, some of them go earlier because of the distance.
Mm-hmm.
It's a big challenge. Also for some teachers,
mm-hmm.
their distance is a challenge. Commuting, sometimes we don't get vehicles, sometimes we get, especially after long holiday
mm-hmm.
or after weekends. But due to determination,
mm-hmm.
we shall conquer.
Mm-hmm.
Then another challenge, we also have, as I said earlier, challenges of water.
Yes.
Especially drinking water.
Yes.
Yeah. When totally dry,
mm-hmm.
things are always hard. But we usually call in the NGOs like Konzan, Worldwide, the Pasita,
mm-hmm.
and others.
Mm-hmm.
They come in with some water tanks
mm-hmm.
to assist community
mm-hmm.
through clean water
mm-hmm.
on their vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
So when they come here, they drop some water here
mm-hmm.
in our tank.
Yes.
That's how we do survive. Sometimes, not always.
Okay. That's great. Yeah. So good.
Okay.
And you know, they are coming from water point.
Yes.
They are going for...
Mm.
For they are going for pasture.
Yes. So where do they take the water?
From North Horr point.
North Horr.
Yeah.
How many kilometers from here?
Around 10 kilometers.
Mm.
It's not far.
Okay.
It's not far.
It's not far.
Mwalimu, I understand that because it's very hot, people sleep outside. Is it real?
Exactly.
It's real?
It's real.
Really?
You know, during, especially during hot days.
Yes. What do you mean?
Inside is just
for cooking.
Sometimes just entertaining for short stay.
Mm-hmm.
But you spend most of the time.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
So what will lala nje?
Lala nje and very secured.
For real?
Very secured.
What about the hyena?
Hyena?
Eh.
We have sent the school.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Just hear
yeah,
their sound. Yeah. The only animals that come in, like, they are small animals, like squirrels.
Mm-hmm.
Hairs.
Hey.
Like you can see, these are the teacher's quarters.
Oh, teacher's quarters.
Have some rooms here.
Yes.
So, teachers here.
Okay.
Yeah. So, during hot days,
hey.
We converse here.
Uh-huh.
We sleep outside.
Okay. Have you ever experienced yourself? Have you ever slept outside?
Daily. most of the days.
Hey.
Yeah, yeah.
You sleep outside? Yeah, because it's really very hot, you know?
The local community is very It's very cool, very welcome. It's very good amount.
Yeah, sure. Sure, sir. So this is the.
Now this is my residential.
Okay.
This is for deputy head of institution.
Okay. Okay.
I was given last year.
Okay, so you reside
I
in this
reside
place.
Here, yeah.
Okay, that's a nice money. Okay.
You can use the other door.
Okay.
And we have neighbors. Uh-huh. Community manager.
Yeah. So those are the Manyata.
A very wonderful community.
Indeed.
We coexist very well.
Uh-huh.
A pastoralist in nature.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And
Bwana Wanyama,
yes.
Tell us when did this school started?
Okay, the institution began last 20 years ago.
Yes.
It is like 2004-2005,
uh-huh.
Whereby it was an initiative of the local community.
Uh-huh.
And the Catholic mission,
yes.
Whereby they put up all resources,
mm-hmm.
Then they began ECD.
Okay.
Then during those times it was 8 proposed systems, that's
mm-hmm.
class 1.
Mm-hmm.
Then it moved gradually up to today,
mm-hmm.
it's 9 junior secondary.
Okay.
So it is around 20 years down the line.
Okay.
It's an old school.
Okay.
So this is our main water tank to use.
Mr. Wabuche, what have you learned from this community? Because I've been here for so long. 10 years is not a small number, my friend. You've been patient for this long. Harsh environment.
Country like Dubai,
mm-hmm.
then South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So recently I worked in a country known as Rwanda,
mm-hmm.
in Kigali,
okay.
some years back,
mm-hmm.
and I'm doing some research
mm-hmm.
with a country called Cameroon,
okay.
so that I check the international standards
mm-hmm.
of East and West Africa
mm-hmm.
in terms of education system.
Yes.
So for this CPC, I'm really trying to work around the clock
mm-hmm.
to see how these countries contract
yes.
in terms of nurturing these young ones.
Okay.
So from here, when I go further beyond Africa,
mm.
as a young teacher,
mm.
I'll be proud.
Yes.
And I'm doing something to ensure my aspirations are true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That is amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Wanyama.
And God bless you.
God bless
Welcome
you too.
Welcome again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The national
and this all heads to